we going to say today? And he's like, they'll channel through something. Focusing on him, it was like, oh yeah, we're in the zone.
I don't know. This feels like, Zarina, there's something you need to share. I don't know. There's something you want to share, or something you can bring forward. Like you do the Silva method, you do other kinds of things, and you've helped Lada and other people to sort of tap in and feel.
Just maybe my observations about astrology. You know, planets are just an expression of the divine, of creator, you know, so you're not worshiping something else. This is an expression of the divine. It's not a person, or at least this is how I perceived it. And then I thought, it is all about perception and how you look at things. I mean, you can look at astrology in a very scared way, as in, you know, this is like extreme Christians do. This is a threat. This is a devil stuff. You can worship astrology, like this is the entire truth, but in the end, it's how you interpret it. It's your understanding of astrology and what you make out of it. In the end, what I think astrology is important for is helping people find peace, get oriented a little bit. For me, it's a psychological tool. It's not so much predictive, because do you really want the prediction, or do you want the peace of heart that the prediction will give you, that things will get better? In the end, people want to feel at peace, that things will be fine, that they will be okay, or that everything is okay at the moment.
When you're looking at astrology, or you're looking at any of that, it's like even native spirituality, like we have ceremonies that involve a lot of different things. Those different things connect you on different kinds of levels. It's like the Christians, they have their Bible. When they hold that Bible, it's like everything. It's like all the laws and all the knowledge. But even in the Bible, it talks about astrology. Even the three magi, they used it to prophesize and know that when Joshua ben Joseph was born, in there, they also have numbers. And the numbers are a language. And if you learn that language, you can discover and learn all kinds of stuff. So having little tools and different things connects you. Sometimes it helps you to ground and hold that energy so you feel safe, so that you will open up and connecting to other people on that level. So that was part of my process of venturing forwards after my granddad died. I didn't really have anybody to talk to at 17. He was gone. And I talked to other people and they all thought I was crazy. And so I just started searching out books. Like he always told me, read, study, learn, ask questions. And that was a repetitive thing he always told me. It's like, always do this, because one day you will understand. And even like going into Tibetan Buddhism, which is foreign to me, and buying books and reading and trying to understand the Dalai Lama. Why do people pray to him? And why do they pray to the Pope? Why do they pray to the Queen of England? Why do different forms and their doorways or connections and that sort of makes you feel safe. While you're in there, there's something that you believe. And it's like, I like carrying stones. I like going to tarot readers. I like doing this because they're on some level, they're connected to something. And there's a light source and it's connected it through everything. So these are just mediums. These are just different things. It's like having all kinds of different books and knowledge. All those books, they expand you. So you can reach out and read what this person says, or why in this faith or philosophy it has this. So all of them have good things. And I like Crassey's talismans. I like Ian's suggestions of remedies. I like Ruman and others. They give you these little things that sometimes allows you to hold an energy to expand in. And once you're safe, you move past that. Sometimes you'll put that object away, and then later on, you might come back and pick it up. Like in my medicine bag, I have two pipes, one I made Cindy 10 years ago, and one that is mine, and I carry those in my medicine bag. I don't use them all the time. Like when we did the night lodge, I had to bring it out because I had the medicine man come in. And I had to smoke my pipe with him for everybody. And I had to give the pipe to the creator and ask spirits to come in. bless and help everybody and had to give the flags and the tobacco and the offerings like that. And these all symbolize something to me. So I can lift the Bible and I can carry it around. I could use it either as a Christian and in that form, or I can say, well, in this book, which is actually taken from 64 other books, because the Bible is just a little pieces, portions from 64 other books that was compiled in this little thing they called the Holy Bible. If you had all 64 books, you can read every one of them and get a lot more depth and a lot more knowledge, because there's things that were hidden and kept out. So we need these little kinds of things to assist us in moving forward. So like I say, everybody feels different. It depends on how badly you were ingrained when you're growing up and what is your challenge from releasing and moving past that and realizing everything came from the Creator. From the first time this planet was born and humans started walking on it, all the knowledge came, and it came from out there somewhere. It came to assist us to evolve, but it got distorted over time. And then there's superstitions and fears and other kinds of things that get mixed in and all. And it gets very confusing searching through all of that. So,
yeah, I feel that that's the topic that we have here today is knowledge. Just like Mercedes had knowledge in her that she forgot that she even had, and then a situation arose to remind you that you know what to do. Where that girl is just like, Cindy, you know so much. And I'm like, no, I don't. And then, oh, actually I do. You know, recognizing that we have access to the information that we do need in some way or another. Like, we know we've come across this path before. Now, how do we start filtering through what we do already know? And then how do we let in new knowledge that we are unaware of, right? There's some kind of curiosity that we do have that Joe was talking about earlier. When he comes across something, he gets really curious about it. So he starts asking questions. And then different books come to him, which he asks different questions. That's watching YouTube videos. That's the Mateus initiation thing, right? It just gives you all these different perspectives. And how Joe says that everything comes from Creator, everything that we have here in the physical world, but also in the unseen world. And there's many lifetimes that we've lived. And then there's that Akashic Records that holds the records of everything that you have experienced through every lifetime. Well, if this is your record of your experiences and your knowledge, why can you not ask to retrieve that knowledge if you've earned it in other lifetimes? How it comes into you may be beyond your comprehension, but there's that asking. I asked to retrieve the wisdom that I've earned in other lifetimes into this lifetime so that I can help this world shift into a better place or shift into the future. As long as I feel that your intention is about that, the future and the evolution and the growth and the expansion and helping humanity in whatever way it is, then you're going to be using it in the proper way, that I feel like there's an alignment that happens there with that knowledge. And it can just download into you, or it can come to you in a book, or, you know, Ian might say it for Sonia in this meditation. You just don't know how it will come, but asking for it.
Because everything carries a vibration too. It's like you can get a crystal that, say, some people say in the New Age belief is there are crystals that have been programmed from the Lemurian. So if you get that right crystal that was yours, it's going to open up and show you everything about the time of Lemuria, and you might have stored all the records in it so you can access all the knowledge from that time to now help this planet go forward. I have a niece, when she was a little girl, she'd be walking around and a rock would call to her. So she'd just be playing, and all of a sudden she'd hear a voice, and she'd start searching around, and she would find a rock and pick it up. And when she picked it up, it was like a TV screen would activate, and she'd start telling you, she'd tell you about dinosaurs, she'd tell you about tribal people, she'd tell you all kinds of stuff from holding this crystal, and she would hear it, and she would be able to tell you whatever it was saying, and she would be able to see it. And she would say, this is mine, and she would take it home, and her dad sort of got tired, because everywhere they went, a rock would call to her. And all of a sudden she's picking it up, and she just opened up and just starts saying all the stuff she's seeing. And she had this great big pile of rocks in her bedroom, like in the corner, that just kept piling these rocks. and her dad get very tired because everywhere they go, she's like, oh, and he would try to sometimes throw the rock away because it's like she had so much in her bedroom. And she would go and search for it. And sure enough, she'd find it because she'd call for the rock and then would call her eventually and she'd pick it up and say, well, it's coming home with me. So those vibrations are very important. That's where expanding and trusting is. It's like even reading, what's his name, The Sleeping Prophet?
Edgar Casey.
Edgar Casey, and how he could put a book under his head and absorb all the knowledge or different things. People have different ways to do things. In the natives, when we do ceremonies, we make an altar and we place what we believe is sacred on that altar. We place crystals, we put pipes, tobacco, all kinds of different things on these altars. We go to some of the night lodges and that, they'll have a big buffalo skull and they'll put rattles and all kinds of stuff that the spirits will use in the ceremony. So for everybody, we have something, whether it's a carnelian, whether it's a clear crystal, whether it's a ring or a talisman or a symbol or something, it all activates something in us. There's an energy vibration that, like I say, it makes us feel safe to expand out. It connects us to other people. It connects us to something that, okay, we're learning and growing in this. Maybe in a year or two, I'm going to move on from it. But right now, this is where I am, and it makes me feel very wonderful and good. So I feel safe, and I'm going to do it. Some other people might feel it's a threat, and it's wrong, and have many other reasons why that shouldn't be. But that's their own inner stuff. But find what is yours and work with it and grow with it.
I suggest to ask the universe, your guides, so that you can have an experience of creator's energy, like a big experience where you feel safe, but that you have that, for yourself as a reference. And it will come whenever it comes, that it's right for you. But there's that thing where Joe says you're guides are up there playing solitaire, looking down every now and then saying, oh, is she going to ask? Waiting for you to ask the question. So ask to have a big experience of creator's energy. What does it feel like to connect with a higher vibrational energy? And when I'm in that energy, to feel safe, you know, and because it's like being the master of your mind, I've learned that when you're in that big energy, when you think a certain thought, things can happen. Things can get bigger. So it's sort of like preparing your thinking process so that when that big energy flows straight through you, that you're also thinking of that next thought that energy can go to and expand in your life. You know, so I was listening to Joe Dispenza's workshop, the progressive workshop, and he was saying that it was at the end of the whole weekend, and he was saying his closing goodbye, but the energy in the room had built up so high, it was like a wave came off of all the people, and it went down, and then it went into like his abdomen, and went up his spine, blew out his head, and then came back down through him, and then poof, like out like a sonic wave out to all the people that were in there. And it shook him so much that he didn't know what to say. And he's like, I couldn't finish the close. It was like anything I could do to get off that stage fast was what I had to do. So he got out and he raced back to his hotel room. And by the time he got to his hotel room, he's trying to put his key in the door. The security of the hotel was standing beside him, and the events manager is standing beside him, and they think that he's dealing ecstasy to all of his participants. they're wondering if he's been giving them drugs because of the high energy that was coming off of everybody. So and he was still trying to process what he was in, and it's not something that he did, it's something that just happened. So when I'm hearing this, like I had listened to it before, but I'm listening to it again, all of a sudden I was like, I've had a similar experience. And it's like, what do you do when you're in that energy is, you know, where your thoughts go. And that's what we're doing here in this meditation. And this is what we're doing with our curiosities, is we're expanding our space so much bigger. How do we take our thoughts to a higher place? because the future is happening today, right? We are moving forwards, and we want to be on that trajectory of that change. How do we do it? And it's like working with that vibrational energy and having experiences for yourself, not always looking at, let's say, Joe, you know, oh, only people like him can have that experience, you know, in the spiritual world. It's like, no, you can too.
So. Yeah, everybody, that's what the universe says, is that everybody can get into that light. And I always say, be a clear channel, own your light, walk in it, grow, expand as big as you can, and give permission to evolve and change, because our brains want to hold on to something because it only relies on the past memories and it tries to move that way. So some things that come in new, yeah, we don't understand, and we're really easy to step out and just sort of push it aside, going, well, I need this experience. I'm not sure what it is, but, and like Dispenza, that light gets really big and there is something that will come off. It's like us all meditating. We're all allowing the creator and the light and the energy to expand out around, so we can all have profound experiences, even though we're in different parts of the world or whatever. And that is there, and that opportunity in the native ceremonies, the elders always say, I might have all of this, but maybe today the creator is waiting for your prayer or your prayer. So just because I have all of this and I do this doesn't mean that it's going to be my prayer that's going to open that door. Sometimes it's somebody else's prayer. And when we're in these groups, the creator is listening. And it's like, how big do you want to make this? How big do you want to expand or assist other people in their growth? And that opportunity is there for everybody to bring that forwards, because there's something inside us we all have that will come forwards if we're really open and trusting and allowing.